antipathy in climate as I steel myself to battle the fierce weather conditions to see today's property.
What's not to love about Wales in the rain? Anyway, I'm here to see. Hey, three bed, mid terrace. Can I take £48,000?
Oh, my word. Right. And breathe. So, what have we got? Well, that's kind of interesting. Straight through the front door, stairs up to your bedrooms there, but then this room. Now, you know me, I'm all about open plan, but they've tried to create this front room area by opening up this wall, and it's got this sort of strange archway thing going on. And it just doesn't work. If that wall was gone, then it'd be all right, but as it is, it's a nice size space, but straight away you can see the house is in a bit of a state. Lots of belongings, which always is a difficult thing when you go into a house to view it, the previous occupant's belongings. But let's try and just look at what we've actually got. So nice views out to the garden here, this rear room. But again, that wall with that little opening on it, it's all a bit weird. If that was all opened up, it would be great. But as it is, it doesn't quite work. I mean, you can tell sort of the house needs a complete refurbishment. So this is a sort of back to bricks renovation job. But we've got a lot of space. I mean, I like the space. It's a good sized house. And this kitchen area, although obviously you want to replace absolutely everything, is a good space. So, you know, see through what it is right now to what it might become. I think we've got some good potential. Well, now that I've caught my breath, I see that, strangely, there is an extra front door to the property that I only caught a glimpse of as I battle my way in here. That could come in handy, as the place definitely needs a good blast of wind blowing through it to help you clear it out. So upstairs, as you might have imagined, it's in a similar sort of state. In fact, there's even more of the previous occupants' belongings. So what have we got? Two good-sized double bedrooms, one at the rear of the property, one at the front. That one's got a boiler in it. Never ideal to have a boiler in a bedroom. Certainly extra good reasons to have it checked out, make sure that it's gas safe. But the bathroom's up here. It needs complete refurbishment. A smaller third bedroom, but at least it is a third bedroom. And again, coming back to this, it's a good-sized family house with lots of potential. One thing I haven't mentioned, though, which is slightly more intrinsically potentially problematic, is that it's non-standard construction. There's lots of things which give that away. And if you look around the properties in this little part of Upper Vale, a lot of them are built like this. Now, I do understand it's a type of non-standard construction, because yes, it gets even more complicated. Not all non-standard construction is the same. It's a type of non-standard construction, which is generally regarded as one of the better types of non-standard construction. Therefore, things like getting a mortgage on it might be less problematic than with other types of non-standard construction, but it's definitely something you need to check out. And as with all things to do with property, as long as you're forewarned, you're forearmed. So, a couple of caveats with this concrete-built three-bed mid-terrace. But still, you can't complain about that £48,000 guide price, can you? Let's see what a local estate agent thinks of the place.
It needs a lot of work. It is a full renovation, but it's got bags of potential. The garden's fantastic, backs onto greenery to the rear. But yeah, these ones do work well. They're a large ex-council property. In terms of the layout with the kitchen and dining, actually, it's quite a tidy layout for what people want now. Second door would be more than likely for when they used to bring the coal through, so you don't have to traipse through the front door. But no, the kitchen diner, most people want these days.
Ah, so that explains the additional front door. And yes, it could come in useful for clearing things out and bringing building materials in. So what could this place be worth once it's been done up?
On the sales market, this would be around £90,000 to £100,000.
And how about if the new owner intended to rent it out instead?
Rental market's picking up well once done, and we are getting premiums we're seeing at the moment, so I'd estimate around about £500 per calendar month.
I guess in some ways this is a classic auction property. It is in a state where you've got to see through what it looks like now to what it could become. value in this one? I think so. Let's see who agreed when he went under the hammer.
23 then is 3rd Street, Cardiff. It's a mid-terrace property, probably requires some upgrading. We have a proxy bid on this, guided at 48. Wave a hand at me at, I don't know, £40,000 when you start the bidding. Wave a hand at 40. Thank you very much. I've got you at 40. At 40. 41 then on the proxy. 41. 42, will you? 42, thank you. 42. 43. 44.
A proxy bid is a bid placed by an interested party that cannot make it to the auction house on the day of the auction. So the auctioneer bids on their behalf until an agreed-upon limit has been reached. But the proxy in this case was outbid. We rejoin at 52,000.
52,000 on my right-hand side. The first time, second time, 53. Madam, feel free to scream and shout if I can't see you. 53.
Zat je vaak op zo bij je veiling dat de mensen gapen en zo? Gapen de mensen?
6.5, 7.5. No, at £57,000 I'm with you, sir. For the first time, second time, third and last time, at £57,000. You'll say your number, please. 25, thank you very much.
Snapping up this three-bed mid-terrace with that successful £57,000 bid was Simon. Legal worker Simon and his electrician brother Tristan have been on the show before when they renovated this rather leaky end terrace in Combe just along the road. They had inherited their grandfather's estate and decided that investing in property together was going to be a good way of putting that money to work, with this property being next on their list. We met up back at the house to chat about their plans for it. Tristan, Simon, good to see you again.
Morning.
Another property in Wales. Tell me why you wanted to buy this one.
I thought it's a lot of potential. It has lots of space inside it. It's nice and spacious and airy. And we thought we could do some nice things with it.
Okay, and the state of it, were you okay with that?
That's what it appealed to me.
Oh, really?
I wanted buy the worst house on the best street.
Oh, right.
I want to come in and completely gut it and bring it back to what it should be as a family home.
Right. So tell me how you're going to do that. What's the plan?
Well, this property is going to be a complete strip back, rewire, replaster, replumb. Boiler's in a stupid location, so we're going to bring it downstairs into the utility area. And this will be a complete facelift inside and out, paint the outside, clean it down, clean the garden up. Sort the drive out so it's usable.
Get rid of the rubbish.
Get rid of the rubbish and new windows where they're needed, but we think they're all needed, so pretty much everything.
So, right, a complete refurb.
Absolutely.
How much of that can you do? Because you've got an electrician, which is a great start.
Absolutely.
That's what most people have to bring in.
We can do a lot of it ourselves. We've got a group of guys that we trust to get on with the works, that we know the work quality they do, and we know the standard they will get it to and the speed they will get it to, because we want to be able to do it quite quickly. And as long as we can get the emptied ready for them, we can get on with it.
And I will come as and when needed. I mean, ideally, I don't want to get my hands dirty. I'll come and supervise. I'll bring the kids with me. They can move all the rubbish out onto the front and we'll have it collected. We'll empty the stuff upstairs. We'll empty the attic that's full. And just monitor it, make sure everything's moving on target and to budget.
So what is the budget?
15,000 with a contingency of 5.
The one thing we haven't talked about is the fact it is North Sound construction.
Mm-hmm.
Were you aware of that when you bought it? Was that a concern?
No.
Because?
The house two doors down sold 6 months ago and it's got a mortgage on it.
Right.
So it wasn't concerned.
So because this particular type of North Sound construction is actually...
Is mortgageable,
but not all sorts are.
No, that's right.
And we did talk to some friends that are mortgage advisors who said... You can mortgage them, but not the whole market covers it. It's a much smaller percentage, but they are mortgageable generally. So based on that, we thought we're going to secure.
So go for it. So what's the plan for it? Are you going to do it up, rent it out, or do it up and sell it?
No, sell. Do it up and sell.
Okay, move on.
Yeah.
So what's the time scale for sorting it out?
3 months.
3 months, okay. And then on the market.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's all good. Well, I've got you. You're an electrician.
Yeah.
Right. So we often talk on the show about, you know, things you must get in.
Yep.
You can do a lot of stuff,
yep.
DIY, but you can't do some electrics and some, and definitely can't do gas. But what can you do and what can't you do? This is what I've got you.
The rules change or the regulations change often.
Oh, right.
And in the last couple of years, it used to say in the instructions, you can do this if you are competent or qualified. qualified, and they've now removed the word competent, and it just says qualified. So from my perspective, you should be doing very little in a house, but from a DIY's point of view, changing a switch or a light socket is relatively simple.
Right, but for most things now then, you need to get in a qualified electrician.
Absolutely, you should always bring in a professional to do a professional's job, whether it's electrics or gas. Right. It's always worth being safe.
Yeah, oh, definitely, absolutely. You can't put a price on that. Listen, congratulations, good luck.
Thank you very much.
We'll see how you get on.
Thank you.